Hi, everyone. This is Phil Spencer, head of gaming at Microsoft, and welcome to GameStack Live. You know, we'd normally be doing this at GDC, where we'd see all of you, we get to talk to you about the games that you're making, but just like everybody else, we've had to adjust. We did that last year, we're doing it again this year. Now, all of you, you've persevered through a year, and it's been amazing to see the role that gaming has played on the planet to unite and connect people through the joy of play. Gaming has played a more important role on the planet than ever before, and I'm incredibly proud to be part of this industry that has helped lead over the last year. Now, the power of gaming is why Microsoft is all in on gaming and game developers. We're investing in creators across the company, from Azure to Xbox to PlayFab to Visual Studio. In order to give you absolutely the best tools that you need to create the best games and to reach the millions of gamers that you want to reach, we've created an entirely new organization within gaming to help you, the creator, get the best out of the tools and technologies that we build, and equally important, give us the feedback that we need in order to chart our path forward as a company. So let me introduce you to Sarah Bond, head of the Game Creator Experience for Microsoft.
Thank you for the opportunity to introduce my team, the Gaming Ecosystem Organization, which we like to call GEO for short. We created GEO with a clear mission, to empower creators like you to realize your dreams across all platforms, Xbox, PlayStation, Steam, Epic Games Store, iOS, Android, and anywhere games are played. That's why, when lockdown hit last year, our very first thought was of you, the global game creator community. Many of you were in the heat of production for Gen 9 games for the Xbox Series X and S. Some were just activating new dev kits, and production was about to hit full swing, and then the shutdown hit. Like you, our team was all over the world. Shanghai, Sao Paulo, London, Warsaw, Melbourne, Dubai, Paris. Our complete focus was that everyone and their families could be safe. And we didn't want you to feel like you had to choose between medical safety or keeping things running. I remember how in 48 hours, we just pulled out all the stops so that you could bring dev kits home. We changed tooling so you could track hardware and keep it secure while outside the office. And we prioritized management systems to enable remote control and viewing, so it's easier for you to use a kit from anywhere. And we also just upped service capacity as much as we could, so you could meet rising player demand as people turned to gaming for connection and relief in a time of stress and isolation. When I remember that moment, like the best part is that everyone rallied together. We were just all in on finding solutions to enable you to keep doing work and succeed amongst all of the uncertainty that was gripping the planet. And that's what Team GEO is all about, empowering you. We're a team that spans Microsoft, integrating all our tools, technologies, services from DirectX, GitHub, Visual Studio, Azure, and of course, Xbox, to help you create, deliver, and accelerate your games. We're a team set to help you throughout the creative cycle, from concept and development to attracting players and growing through engagement, retention, and monetization. There are lots of ways we can help, but all of them have one thing in common, that you, the game creator, is at the center of what we do. We can make it possible for you to bring your vision to players around the world on Xbox consoles, PC, Game Pass, and xCloud. We can enable you to nurture and grow your communities on every continent using tools that leverage both the power of the global cloud and the latest local hardware. We can help you engage your players longer and smarter with live ops techniques powered by PlayFab that allow you to better understand customers and move quickly to update games with new content. I love our industry and what you do. I spent the last 4 years learning from and with all of you. There's just nothing like walking the halls of your studios or meeting with the teams or getting to brainstorm creative concepts and business innovations together or solving problems and just seeing new tech in action for the first time. And the best part, those like amazing moments when I actually get to put my hands on the controls and experience something that you've created. I've circled the globe countless times. I've learned of the unique and common challenges you face, and I come back every time inspired by you and all that we can do together. But more than anything, I'm inspired because the power of gaming extends far beyond play. Games are the most relevant, prevalent and culturally significant form of entertainment on the planet. As game creators, you conjure worlds. You bring joy, growth, and shared achievement, breaking down barriers to forge true global human connection. You are shaping our generation and the next in ways that no one and no other can. No matter what, at each step along the journey, we're here to listen and learn, to build, innovate, and improve, and ultimately, to empower you to achieve your dreams. This year, it really has been a journey like no other. It's been incredible to see gaming continue to grow and connect people, but none of us were truly prepared for the realities and consequences of long-term isolation. Now it's been over a year, and we feel it personally, and we hear it when we talk to you. Things like having to wait for hours to download gigabytes of files over our home internet before you can even start for the day. The missed experience of sitting together on a sofa and just playing a build. The frustration of not being able to lean over a person's shoulder and just point to a cluster of calibrated pixels on a screen and say, that doesn't look right. Everything, technology, collaboration, creative process has had to be rewritten for this new reality. And despite all these challenges, we're experiencing amazing breakthroughs and wins that we will take forward with us as an industry. Together, we launched Gen 9, the Xbox Series X and S, and the PlayStation 5. And so many of you were part of that epic moment, doing the heavy lifting to develop and shift new games and optimizations of titles. We learned how to make distributed development work better than ever, unlocking our collective ability to hire the best talent wherever it may be, anywhere in the world. And we move more of our on-premise production pipelines to the cloud, accelerating modern DevOps techniques and all the goodness around iteration and efficiency that come with it. We adapted and an entire industry thrived. I've loved seeing the continued success of large-scale titles like Roblox, including them basically becoming the de facto school-at-home recess alternative for kids around the globe. It's been so cool how we shipped Gen 9 blockbusters like Sega's amazing Yakuza Like a Dragon or gorgeous games from independent developers like Call of the Sea from Out of the Blue. And in a time of isolation, gaming showcased its power to build social connection through experiences like Genshin Impact, Fall Guys, Among Us, Animal Crossing, and Megastorm's Shotgun Farmers, a wonderful multiplayer game that was one of my favorites this last year. And as art form, we went beyond connection. We led the way in cultural relevance by engaging and generating awareness for every aspect of society through games like Last of Us Part II, Tell Me Why, and Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales. This is a time we in gaming can be truly proud of. We have set records across the board. Gaming is the fastest and largest form of media and entertainment, closing in on a $200 billion global industry. There's been many wins, but one thing that we lost is the opportunity to catch up and just connect in person at events that have long been the heartbeat of our industry. To address this and stay grounded and connected with all of you, we created GameStacklive last year in the wake of cancellation of GDC. And we're back this year with what we hope will continue as an annual event. What started as a response to crisis has turned into an opportunity. So with that, welcome to GameStacklive. This year we have over 40 talks covering a full range of topics from pre-launch production pipelines to post-launch analytics, all pre-recorded and captured in 15 languages. This format means we're able to reach more of you than ever before. We're here to help you deliver more great games to more players in more ways. We're here to continue pushing our art form forward, to share our knowledge, to learn from you, and to hear your feedback. And more than anything, to fuel innovation in gaming. I hope that you learned something new, something that inspires you as much as you've all inspired me over the last 4 years. To talk more in detail about this year's show, I'd like to introduce one of the core members of the gaming ecosystem team, James Gwertzman, co-founder and former CEO of PlayFab, and now general manager of Microsoft's Gaming Cloud.
Thanks, Sarah. My favorite part of my job is working with game creators like yourselves, seeing the amazing creative things you do with the technologies and services we provide. That's why I'm especially excited about the lineup of content we have this year. There's so much great learning in there, and I can't wait to see what you do with it. As Phil and Sarah mentioned, COVID has forced us all to reimagine how we build our games. We've all had to embrace team members working from home, and even after we can go back to the office, remote work is here to stay. We have a few talks specifically on this topic. Building games in the cloud with Azure dives into one example of how developers are leveraging the cloud, looking at how Minecraft team at Mojang is building Bedrock using Azure. Bandai Namco will be presenting about how they've made a cloud-native continuous integration build pipeline for games they're making in Unity. And not least, we have a talk called The New Normal, about starting life at Team Xbox without ever setting foot in the office. Phil and Sarah also mentioned how games continue to bring people together. For this topic, we have an entire track specifically dedicated to multiplayer. This has been a big investment area for us this past year, and among our many interesting talks about this are sessions on hosting multiplayer servers in the cloud with PlayFab, using PlayFab Party to add voice and networking to games, and a talk about how the Minecraft team ported Realms over to Azure. I also want to call out the graphics track and the audio track, because both are examples of how we're all continuing to push forward with innovation despite being remote. For graphics, be sure to check out the graphics keynote. In that talk, you're going to get an overview of the various DirectX 12 Ultimate features, including ray tracing and mesh shaders. For audio, check out the next-gen immersive audio talk on spatial sound and project acoustics to see how new audio processors and Gen 9 technologies can help pull players even deeper into the reality of your game. Another great presentation about innovation that didn't stop is the talk on Flight Simulator. Now, this is really a singular achievement, and we're so grateful to have Asobo Studio presenting exactly how they used the power of Azure and Bing Maps to build the digital twin of the planet to enable us all to experience the magic of flight, where you can fly around an entire photorealistic Earth with geometry generated not by hand, but by machine learning algorithms working off of satellite images. This is a product that would have quite literally been impossible to deliver without the cloud, and we're really excited to take you behind the scenes on this remarkable project. The common thread running through much of this content is the cloud. Here at Microsoft, we could not have achieved half of what we've achieved this past year without Azure. A new console launch, a dozen high-profile first-party game launches, thousands of third-party titles, collaboration, game production, testing, multiplayer hosting, live ops, doing all of these things with remote teams amidst an unprecedented surge of player demand depended on Azure. Azure is production ready and battle tested. Sometimes though, the power of the cloud may seem out of reach to smaller game studios. And so, to do something about that, I'm excited to share some news today. You all know about our ID Xbox program, which has helped thousands of indies bring their games to Xbox. Today, we're announcing a new program, ID at Azure, specifically to help everyone take advantage of the power of the cloud and Azure. So whether you're building for mobile, or PC, or PlayStation, or Xbox, this program's for you. And to tell you more, here's Chris Charla, my colleague and head of the ID at program.
Thanks, James. As the head of our ID at Xbox program, I've been blown away by the resilience of the independent developer community over the last year. We've seen more than 500 games launch in 2020, the most ever coming from the ID at Xbox program. And developers in the program have now earned well over $2 billion in royalties, which just feels great when we think about sustainability for independent developers. One thing we've learned over the last 7 years with the ID at Xbox program is that making platform access straightforward and as easy as possible to execute on for creators ensures that developers can focus on innovation in their games and our players have access to the broadest variety of amazing experiences possible. That's why I'm super excited to partner with James and the rest of the gaming org to introduce a new program, ID at Azure, that brings the same developer-forward philosophy and style of ID at Xbox to cloud gaming services. Our goal with ID at Azure is to help developers and studios of all sizes take advantage of the cloud, regardless of the platform you ship on, in a straightforward and easily understandable way. We're excited to announce the program today, and we encourage you to head to this website to sign up to learn more in the coming weeks. Whether you're just learning about cloud services and want to understand what they can do for you and your games, if you're looking for a specific cloud solution for multiplayer or another topic, or if your studio is packed with cloud gaming veterans looking to take your offerings to the next level, we know you're going to find membership in the ID at Azure program a huge benefit for your studio. It's going to be a great event over the next couple of days, so I'll pass back to Phil to officially get us started.
Thanks for joining us and enjoy the event. It's a pleasure to work with each of you, and we look forward to continuing to empower the incredible global community of game developers. Welcome to GameStack Live.